everybody. I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to my craft room. I'm so happy to have you here today. In today's video, we're going to be doing something really fun with our wecreat 10 watt laser. We're actually going to be using the 2 watt infrared head to do this, and we're going to be cutting vinyl. Now, it's really, really important to know this is laser safe vinyl. You cannot cut vinyl like StarCraft, Orcal, Caesar, any of those other types of vinyl. This is from wecreat and this is made to work with a laser. So please do not just go cutting any vinyl or HTV with a laser. Don't do that. It's extremely toxic. This is specifically made to work with a laser. So this is an HTV product. So we have the backing side, which is the vinyl, and then this side is your carrier sheet. You want to make sure that when you cut this, it's just like when you do it with the Cricut, you want to cut it carrier sheet side down. You want to mirror your design. But again, please, please do not just go cutting any kind of vinyl in a laser. You must use laser safe vinyl and HTV. So we're going to be using that today. Wecreat did send me the vinyl to try out, see what we thought. Now, I had to play around a lot with my settings to find the right ones to work. I cut hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of circles trying to find the right settings. So hopefully this video will help you out if you want to try out cutting HTV with the wecreat 10 watt and the 2 watt. So I made this little design. It is really intricate. It did take a while to cut. And we're going to go over all of the settings, how to create your own custom setting, plus how to set up your design so that it will cut. And then I'm gonna go over the press settings with you as well for this, because I did have to try out a few settings till I found what worked best, because they did not give me any press directions, which sometimes happens. So it's always important to have like a random shirt, which this one I just use for testing. That way you can test out like different settings, different press settings and all of that. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we want to do is to insert the image that we want to use into our wecreat software. So I'm just going to drag and drop an SVG in here. My SVG shows as a Microsoft Edge document, but that is in fact an SVG. So you can just drag it and drop it. Now, this is hard to see, A, because it's black, and B, it's a lot of paths. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to merge my graphic shapes just so that it's all one path. It just makes life a little bit easier. And then I'm going to change the color so that we can see it better. I'm just going to make it this bright blue. Now I'm going to size this down. I want to make this about, let's say like, 7 inches high. That's probably a good one. But you'll notice that my scale changed. I didn't want that to happen. So I'm going to click undo. If that happens to you, make sure that this lock is closed in between your width and your height, and then you can change your sizing. Now that I've got this sized, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my vinyl or my HTV that I'm going to use for this project into my laser. We're ready to put the vinyl into the machine, so I'm going to open this up. And with this HTV, I have tested it, so I've got a corner cut off. You want to make sure that you put it with the carrier sheet side down, which for this is the colored side. I noticed in some of their videos and things, they're not doing that. So you want to make sure that you do, in fact, do that. And then I just look for where the little red dot is, and I just try to get that and make sure it's on to my vinyl. Then we're going to head back over to the computer for our next step. And then I'm going to hit auto measure over here on the computer, and it'll auto measure our design onto that page. Like, it'll show you the vinyl that's in your machine, and you'll see that come up over here on our black piece here. So now we've got our design. Now you can see all my vinyl. I'm going to put this a little bit closer to the edge, but another thing that I need to make sure that I do is I am going to make sure that I have this design mirrored, because when you're working with HTV, you need to mirror your image, which you can simply do by coming up here to flip, and you want to flip it horizontally so that it's backwards. Now that the lid's closed, I'm going to show you how to set up a custom material setting for these. So I'm using my 2-watt laser, which is what's recommended for this type of the vinyl. Now you can see I have a couple here that I've tested out. So what you want to do, if you want to add a custom one, typically yours is going to start on like an acrylic or a wood setting, depending on what you have. Then I'm going to go down to where it says customization, and I'm going to click add. And then I'm going to call this vinyl 4, just so I know like what it is, if I spell it correctly. Vinyl 4. That way I know what it is for. And then for the thickness, I set it at 1.5, and then I'm going to do a cut setting.
I want my power at 100 and my speed is simply 4. I only wanted to do one pass and then I just click save. Also, I want you to note that when you're cutting this laser safe vinyl from wecreat, the glitter HTV needs to be cut with your 10 watt laser head. And you can also cut the standard HTV that way. But if you're going to be cutting just the standard, you can use the 2 watt, which is what I'm going to use in this video. I just think it worked better. I tried the 10 watt and I like the way the 2 watt cut the HTV much better. Then I can select the setting that I've created for it, select my thickness, and click confirm. Now from here, you can click start on your software. It's gonna process over here, and it's going to give us our estimated processing time, which says 41 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and send this over to our laser. I'll hit the button on the front, and we can get started. Over here at the laser, I'm gonna hit the button on the front and it's gonna get started. Now this is incredibly slow, so I do have a feeling that this is gonna take a while. Now I did speed this up just so you know, and the total cut time for this was around 20 minutes, which is a pretty long time, so do keep that in mind when you are thinking about cutting vinyl or HTV with your laser. And again, make sure you're using a laser safe product. I'm going to say that a lot in this video, but I just want to make sure that nobody poisons themselves with toxins, so use laser safe vinyl or HTV. But this did take quite a while to cut, so that's something to keep in mind if you're thinking about doing this with your laser. Once it's done, you can go ahead and take out your vinyl, and we're gonna go down and see how this weeds. But I'll give you kind of an up close look, kind of see, you can really see the cuts really well. And then I just wanna show you like the back. You can't really see it because it doesn't cut through this carrier sheet. So let's head down, get our pin pen and see how this weeds. Now, as someone who has weeded so much HTV in her life, I can say that this HTV rips a lot easier, but it's not because of the cut setting, it's just because of how that HTV was made. So I think because this is a different type of material, it's going to rip and tear a little easier, which you can kind of see by all like the little pieces. Like I wasn't able to just pull the background off in one fell swoop like I can with some other HTV. But again, I don't think it's because of the quality, I just think it's because of the type of material that it needs to be made out of to make it laser safe. Otherwise, it did weed really pretty easily, other than like all the small like rips that I had to deal with, but it came out pretty nice and everything was fairly easy. Now, I did find that pressing this at 305 for 20 seconds was the answer. And also make sure you allow this to cool completely because this is a cool peel product. So I tried to peel it hot and it tried to rip up. So I waited and I peeled it cool and it worked really well. I think the HTV in general is pretty easy to work with. I just think they need to add the heat press settings to their product on the website, which I will definitely give them these settings because they worked really nice. I think it's really nice. It's matte, it's stretchy, it feels really thin, which I like. It doesn't feel like a really heavy, thick product. Now, again, I want to remind you that you cannot just cut any HTV or vinyl in your laser. You need to use a laser safe product for this. So you need to use vinyl that is specifically made to go in a laser. If you try to use any other vinyl, it's going to be extremely toxic and dangerous. So please do not do that. I will link below this vinyl plus the laser that I used and the laser head for this because I think it came out really, really nice. Be sure to use my code also listed down below. That way you can save $50 off of your order. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure you're subscribed here. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun crafty content. And as always, happy crafting.